Three major tropical storms dominated the 2017 Atlantic hurricane season: Harvey, Irma, and Maria. These destructive hurricanes all occurred within 4 weeks of one another and created unprecedented challenges for coastal communities, weather forecasters, and emergency first responders. Fortunately, the Advanced Baseline Imager on the GOES-16 satellite tracked these record-setting storms and supplied critical data to weather forecasters and emergency management coordinators. Harvey was a long-lived and slow-moving tropical storm that made landfall in Texas as a Category 4 hurricane on August 26th, before stalling out over the Texas coast. Over the next 4 days, Harvey dropped historic rainfall amounts on southeastern Texas, with some places receiving more than 60 inches of rain. The weight of that relentless rainfall caused Houston to physically sink into the ground temporarily by around 2 centimeters. These rains established Harvey as the wettest tropical hurricane ever recorded in the contiguous United States and the second most costly hurricane in U.S. weather history. At least 68 people lost their lives from the direct effects of Hurricane Harvey. All but 3 of those deaths were from inland freshwater flooding, and no deaths were attributed to the hurricane's storm surges. Hurricane Irma developed quickly into a Category 5 system in early September, causing catastrophic damage to the United States and British Virgin Islands. Irma next hit northern Cuba before weakening slightly while heading toward the Florida Keys, making landfall on September 10th with Category 4 winds. Irma caused significant damage to a majority of the buildings in the Florida Keys. Irma then continued north and made landfall on Marco Island, Florida as a Category 3 storm, continuing to generate heavy rains, strong winds, and storm surges that caused coastal flooding from Jacksonville, Florida to as far north as the Carolinas. Hurricane Maria, the strongest tropical storm of 2017, quickly reached Category 5 intensity before making landfall on the island of Dominica on September 18th. Maria caused catastrophic damage and 3 dozen fatalities. Maria next made landfall on the island of Puerto Rico on September 20th with Category 4 winds, devastating Puerto Rico's transportation, agriculture, communication, and energy infrastructure. Extreme rainfall totals of up to 37 inches caused widespread flooding and mudslides across the Commonwealth. The Federal Emergency Management Agency, or FEMA, reports that federal assistance to Puerto Rico has topped $1 billion, and recovery continues. Although not yet operational, data from NOAA's GOES-16 satellite proved vital to forecasting operations as Hurricane Maria neared Puerto Rico, especially when the extreme winds destroyed the weather radar and station in San Juan. Rapid scan data from the GOES-16 Advanced Baseline Imager filled these critical gaps and more, enabling forecasters to track the deadly storm in near real time.